Start, okay. So today we're going to cover about apa ni ah? Microprocessor. Tahu kan microprocessor tu apa kan? So basically, mana nak mengajar ni? Basically, saya share entire screen. Where is it? Where's my function? You are presenting. Change. How do I change this one? Sini saya nak tukar entire screen. You are presenting. Stop presenting. Yeah, I try it. Cannot stop. Wait. Okay. How to stop presenting? Okay, share entire screen. Okay.
Sir, ada orang tak boleh masuk lagi, sir?
Ya? Yeah?
Ada orang tak boleh masuk lagi.
Ada orang tak boleh masuk lagi?
Dia kata error.
Error?
Ha.
Oh, apa error lah? Okay. So this is how the screen look like. Besar sangat. Tak boleh kecil lagi. Okay, tak apalah. Okay. Saya kena tengok yang skrin sebelah ni sebab takut ada kawan you all yang nak masuk. Boleh eh? Macam ni. Okay. So, kita mula eh. Okay, so basically, we going to continue with chapter 3 lah. Previously, we already cover the final topic in chapter 2, which is IEEE number. Okay. So, from chapter 3, 4 and 5, it will be mostly on theory part. Okay. So today we're going to discuss about benda yang paling you all suka lah, CPU. Tanya apa pun pasal komputer, rasa you all jawab CPU kan. Okay. So basically, when you are talking about CPU, okay, we have to recall balik lah. Okay. So we have to recall back the most important element on any system unit. Okay. Benda yang paling penting atas system unit adalah benda yang kita panggil sebagai benda yang paling besar tu lah. Ini kita panggil dia sebagai motherboard. Okay. So on top of motherboard, as we previously discussed, okay, atas motherboard, now what did we discuss? So as we previously discussed, benda yang attached on motherboard, okay, yang attached atas motherboard will be, let's say the first one is the CMOS, okay, the CMOS batteries, okay. So CMOS, kenapa dia penting? Because it will hold the other part lah, the important data about our computer inside the BIOS, okay. So kalau CMOS battery tu problem, so what will happen is all our BIOS data will keep resetting because BIOS dia punya characteristic is volatile. Okay, so it need concern battery power. So basically kat sini ada battery. Okay, so this is the most important thing on motherboard. Okay, so aside from that, motherboard also supply us with the other thing. Okay, yang panjangan. Okay, so on top of motherboard, there will always be a bus line. Okay, so ada bus line. Okay. So why we call it bus, as you already know, because it's carry a lot of passenger at same time. Okay, so in a bus line, dia akan bawa data, dia akan bawa address, and juga dia akan bawa the control. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so this bus line basically dia akan connectkan kita dengan the other part. Okay, dia akan connectkan between our storage and also our storage lah, and also our memory. Okay, so maksudnya our bus line, okay, so dia akan connectkan kita. Okay, selain our bus line, dia akan connectkan kita dengan yang penting, the first one. Okay, yang paling external sekali adalah let's say storage. Okay, so storage, when we talk about storage, it can be anything. Can be the secondary or the main storage. Okay, maksudnya kalau secondary, external and so on, ataupun you punya hard disk. Okay, and then the other one, okay, storage, main. Okay, storage kita define lah, main storage. Okay, which is your hard disk lah. Okay, right? Or to your secondary storage. Okay, so let's say we put a secondary storage there. Secondary storage. Oh, it's not secondary. This is secondary storage. Okay, so this is secondary storage. Okay, and this will be external. Okay, external storage. Okay, and also bus line also connect us with our external, all our peripheral devices. Okay, with our so when we talk about peripheral devices ni, basically we are talking about our, what we call that, our input and output devices lah, including what that, our communication device. Okay, so the most important thing, it also will connect us with our main memory. Okay, you connect with our main memory. So that's the idea of this bus line. Maksudnya, this bus line dia akan connect to all of this. Okay, so how to connect? Okay, so this one, this one, this one. So, okay, cantik. Yellow. Okay, so that's the function of the bus line. Okay, so why we need to connect all of this? Because in the end, okay, macam manusia lah. Okay, in the end, a computer need to be processed. Okay, all the instruction in the computer in the end will be processed. Column. Okay, so in the end, all the thing in computer will be processed by who? By this thing. Okay, so that's why we need to connect it. Okay, so in the end, a computer will be processed by your most favorite thing, which is called CPU. Okay, CPU. Okay. Alright, so this is how it connected lah, roughly. Okay, so inside CPU. Okay, so kita akan discuss about CPU lah. Actually, today, chapter 3, we will cover about CPU. Okay, so what is CPU? Okay, so let's look at the notes. So, microprocessor, CPU stand for Central Processing Unit, which are now the processing unit is in term of micro, so very small compared to the first and second generation of computer. Okay, so what we will cover in this chapter, basically the introduction to microprocessor, the processor machine cycle, okay, and also the CPU component. So this is very general component. So when we talk about register, there are a lot kind of register. Okay, the next one, yang ni you boleh baca lah. Kalau saya baca pun jadi boring. So basically it's the brain lah. Kita kena bayangkan CPU ni macam kepala kita. Okay. So content what? So this one you have to remember back the generation of computer. Maksudnya when you talk about first generation of computer, dia punya CPU akan dalam bentuk yang light bulb tu. Apa tu namanya? I forgot what it's called. Lampu Aladdin, lampu Frankenstein tu. Ala yang mentol. Forgot. What do we call that? Ah, huh? Yang lampu tu, macam lampu tu berkelip-kelip tu. Okay. And then after that one, they move to semiconductor. Okay. First generation, second. So semiconductor, they become the VSL and so on tu lah. You have to remember the generation of computer. Okay. So what is for? Okay. So yang paling penting adalah dia akan interpret and carry out the basic instruction. Okay. Dia akan buat. Sebab dalam komputer, vacuum tube. Thank you. Maksudnya berkesan lah saya mengajar dulu kan. Dalam kelas. Okay. So the next one. What is that? Okay. So that is about our main CPU lah. Okay. So apa dia buat itu? Okay. So, inilah baru dia nak perkenalkan nama dia, CPU, also known as CPU. Okay. So tadi dia kata, nampak? Dia contradict. Tadi dia kata CPU ni macam brain. Okay. So then dia kata CPU ni macam heart. Nampak? So CPU ni boleh jadi dua-dua. Okay. So kenapa dia kata CPU ni macam brain tadi? Okay. Because what it can do. Okay. Kenapa dia kata macam brain? Sebab dia interpret and carry out the basic instruction. So, macam mana dia interpret and carry out? Sebab tu dalam CPU dia ada. Ada tak discuss kat sini? Tak ada. Dia ada CU dengan ALU, control unit dengan arithmetic logic unit. That's why kita kata the CPU is the brain. Okay. And why kita kata CPU is the heart? Okay. Because yang ada dekat tajuk asalnya. If you look inside a CPU, there's also a clock. Okay. Clock tu macam jam. Okay. Clock, kalau kita berkata pasal manusia, kalau kita, sebab kita split kan, yeah? So if you are talking about the brain, if is what you think, yeah? So kenapa kita kata heart? Because the clock of your body, maksudnya your heart, dia ada beat, do kan. So it's similar to your heartbeat, yeah? But the CPU heartbeat, CPU beat, okay? The time in CPU is much more faster than your heart lah. Tak adalah dia macam duduk, relax kan. Kalau you jogging ke berlari baru lagi laju dan so on. Dia akan consistent. So how fast it is, kejap lagi kita discuss. Okay. So the next one. Okay. So the heart. Okay. So ni, this is the another definition lah. Okay. So it made up. The semiconductor. Yes. Okay. So but today, so kalau sekarang kita tak nampak lah, even start saya belajar komputer pun saya tak pernah nampak vacuum tube tu. So awal-awal tu macam ni lah, okay. Yang processor yang saya pasang, okay. So kat bawah ni kalau ikut design yang ni, processor yang ni tak elok lah. You know why? Sebab dia tak ada tempat untuk letak heatsink. Okay, Xeon. Kat mana letak heatsink, mana letak sini. Okay. So where is CPU reside? Okay. So this is our motherboard. Basically CPU, you akan nampak benda flat yang besar. Sekarang jarang lah kita pakai CPU yang dalam bentuk cartridge. Okay. So what is inside the CPU itself? Okay. So dalam CPU, okay. So four major component tadi. Kalau kita tengok tadi, dia kata kita nak discuss what is processor. So settle. So what is clock pun roughly dah settle, tapi kita akan go in depth. So and register. So dalam CPU, kalau you tengok benda-benda yang penting, okay, the first one is the clock. This is the most important thing. Okay. Bila you nak beli komputer pun biasanya you will look into the clock. Okay. Without you, sometimes without you knowing it, okay, you just know that people will look into it. Oh, this is good. Okay. And then the next one, yang benda yang kita jarang fikir adalah the instruction control unit ataupun CUD, the control unit. And then the ALU, okay, this is where the add, addition, subtraction, multiplication and so on will be done. And this is where your data will be stored, the register. Okay, so this is the fastest, the most expensive memory yang ada dalam dunia lah. Okay, yang dalam CPU, the register. So dekat luar CPU akan ada juga register, okay, yang kita panggil sebagai cache, cache. Okay, so selepas cache akan ada lagi cache antara CPU dengan motherboard. Okay, and then ada lagi cache atas motherboard. Sebab tu kita ada istilah cache L1, L2 and L3. So after cache and cache and cache, then only you will jumpa RAM. Okay, and then after you jumpa RAM, before you jumpa hard disk, you akan you akan jumpa hard disk lah basically. But there are what you call it, since RAM will never be enough, okay, so kita curi sikit, kita pinjam sikit bahagian daripada hard disk, okay, kita jadikan dia virtual memory, jadikan dia umpama macam RAM, okay, then only we will store our data finally inside our hard disk, our storage, okay. So itu cerita dia. So sorry lah, saya tak boleh nak lukis sebab apa,
tak ada whiteboard.
I miss my marker. Okay, so this is basically the component lah inside your CPU. Okay, so ada memory dia and so on. Okay, so kalau ini maksudnya, this is not the component in CPU. This is basically the component on yang kita lukis tadi lah, the component on our motherboard. Okay, so but inside the CPU, kita try follow this picture. Okay, where was it? This one. Good line, tak penting pun. Okay, so where was it? This one. Ini pun tutup. Sekejap eh. Terus. Okay, so dia mesti ada I.O. Oh, I.O. ALU. Tak payahlah lukis this one. Okay. Yeah. So the next one, ada soalan tak setakat ni? Okay tak? Okay tak? Baru 8 slide. Oh, no. Okay. No. No, no question eh. Okay. Okay, so the next one. Okay, thank you. Okay, next one. Okay, this is the cycle. Okay, so a cycle. Eh, cycle? Kenapa dia tak cerita CPU? Kat mana dia cerita? Sekejap. Oh, ya, kita ikut je lah arahan dia. Okay, so the machine cycle. Okay, so basically machine cycle, dia akan ada empat. Kenapa ada tiga je? Ah, okay, ada empat. Itulah. Kenapa kat sini dia tulis tiga? Yeah, where's my, dia ada one? Memang tiga je. Betulnya ada empat. Ha, yang ni lah ada empat. Okay, tak apa, kita tengok dulu apa dia cerita kat sini. So, bila, when you talk about machine cycle, basically kita akan splitkan kepada empat. Okay, so what it is, kita refer terus kepada gambar dia. Okay, where's the gambar? Gambar apa? Where's the picture? Eh, so when you talk, oh tak ada kat sini. Saya dah tutup yang tadi. Where is it? So basically, ah tak apalah, saya tulis lah. Where was I? Okay, so basically, when you talk about machine cycle, okay, dia akan ada empat lah. Okay, so the first one is fetch. Okay, so fetch. So fetch ni maksudnya, you are fetching. Okay, so fetching can be as far as it could be. Maksudnya fetching, dia boleh jadi fetch data daripada main memory kepada CPU. Okay, ataupun fetching, okay, fetch ni, okay, so fetching data, it can be, okay, daripada hard disk kepada main memory kepada CPU, ataupun daripada external storage kepada main memory kepada CPU, ataupun daripada peripheral devices. Okay, from your camera macam sekarang kan, saya ambil gambar saya yang bercakap sorang-sorang ni, ambil ni, okay, for data tu daripada external, daripada kamera, go to my memory, go to my CPU. Okay, but when you go from memory to CPU, dia akan lalulah cache-cache tadi tu. Okay, so that is fetching. Okay, so the next step, okay, the next structure in apa, cycle yang ada, so selepas you fetch, okay, let's say you dah fetch data daripada memory, so you must know what to do with the data. Ni data apa? Betul tak? Sebab in the end, the data will come in only 1 and 0. Okay. So to understand what is the data is about, okay, since it's come to you in to the CPU in term of 1 and 0, dia kena decode. Okay. Encode. Decoder. Encoder. Ah, okay, betul lah. Decoder. Dia kena decode the binary. Okay, maksudnya dia nak tahu, ini number ke? Kalau number pula nak tahu, this is positive number ke, for a negative number ke, or do you want me to do addition ke? Okay, so that's the idea of decode. Ke nak suruh store ke? Okay, then only after decode, then only it can execute. Maksudnya katakan kalau instruction tu kata add, maksudnya dia akan gunakan ALU untuk buat tambah. Kalau kita kata nak store, dia akan arahkan CU untuk store data ke dalam our main memory. Okay, and then lepas you dah execute, you mesti store balik you punya data. Okay, sebab kita kena ingat register kita terlalu kecil untuk simpan data terlalu lama. Okay, so basically this four, okay, fetch, decode, execute and store is the four process in the machine cycle. Okay, so kita ada fetch, okay, so kita ada decode and then kita ada execute. And the last one, oh kat sini ha, dia tak merahkan. Kenapa dia tak asingkan? Okay, so kita merahkan dia. Okay, and macam mana dia buat? Oh patutlah, tak muat pun. Okay, so the last one dia ada stop. Okay, so what happened there? Okay, so CPU deal with instruction, okay, secara serial lah. Okay, each step, okay, this series is called machine cycle. Okay, kita dah cover. So machine cycle apa dia buat? Decode, execute and store. Okay, so sama je cerita dia. So step 1 fetch, yeah. Step 2 translate, nak buat apa. Okay, then baru CU tahu nak buat apa. And then execute, kalau perlu execute. And then store balik kita punya result dalam kita punya memory. Okay, so see you. Okay, so second one, see you. Wait, kenapa tajuk dia macam pelik? CPU, two major. Okay, so dalam CPU, okay, kita ada dua benda yang penting. Sebab kena ingat CPU ni macam otak kita, okay. So the first one, sebab otak kita lebih canggih daripada CPU, okay. So the first one, so CPU ni kena split pada dua. So the CPU, the first one, we need the control unit, okay. So control unit ni, dia akan give instruction kepada kita punya computer, okay. Dia akan execute the instruction. Maksudnya kat sini baru dia tahu kita nak move data ke, nak fetch data ke, nak execute data ke, and so on. Okay, and then but when you say you want to execute, let's say you want to do add, CU takkan buat dia punya add lah. Okay, so the addition, the subtraction and so on, the AND and OR logic logic process will be done by the arithmetic logic unit, by the ALU. Okay, so yang ini akan bagi tahu apa nak buat, yang ini lebih kurang akan buat kerja dia. Okay, so oh ada kat sini. So this is the definition of CU. This is the brain part. Okay, ni kira macam CU ni macam kalau kita tengok kehidupan ni, macam orang kata benda yang you belajar daripada kecil lah. Macam mana nak jalan, macam mana nak menulis and so on. Okay, but when you talk about ALU ni, benda yang you belajar masa kat tadika, tambah tolak. Masuk sekolah rendah pun belajar tambah tolak. Masuk apa? Lepas sekolah menengah pun tambah tolak. And then you masuk universiti pun belajar balik tambah tolak. Eh, nombor pelik-pelik dengan saya. Okay, so okay, so CU, aside from that, to determine which instruction to be executed, CU reads the content of the program counter. Okay, so ataupun dalam instruction pointer. Okay, so ini dia macam cara kita berfikir. Okay, memanglah CU tu otak. Okay, tapi kadang-kadang bila kita dah berfikir, okay, we need a place to store what we need to do next. CU ni macam apa ni? Program counter ni, PC ni, macam orang kata macam you punya diary lah. You punya organizer. Pukul 9 nak buat apa, pukul 10 nak buat apa and so on. Okay, so bila you dah buat something, you cut. So you go to the next one. Bila you dah cut something, dah do something, you cut. And then you go to the next one. Okay, so instruction are executed sequentially. Okay, unless told otherwise. Biasanya program counter ni dia ikut turutan lah. Okay. And then, tapi kita boleh jump. Okay, kita boleh letak interrupt and so on. Okay. So CU has a memory management unit to supervise the fetching of instruction and data from memory. Okay, that's normal. And then the I/O interface is also part of CU. Okay. So kenapa yang ini penting? Okay. Kenapa CU kena apa ni? CU kena ada semua ni. Okay. Sebab dia kena buat semua kerja. Okay. Sometimes you will feel like there's a buffer, tapi you punya kerja jalan. Okay. So let's say macam bila you buat assignment ni, you do some assignment on your words. Okay. And then you save, you tekan Ctrl S and then you start editing. Okay. You will find that dia tengah saving tu. Okay. And then when you type something while it's saving, especially bila you try to save into your thumb drive, dia akan ada delay. Okay. But even though ada delay, tapi bila you type something kan, okay, dia akan keluar kemudian, macam lambat sikit. Okay. So that's the idea of memory management unit. So dia akan susun priority, nak habiskan kerja siapa dulu. Kerja siapa masuk buffer dulu. Okay, ataupun spooler dulu. And then baru buat, the next one baru buat. Okay. So that's the idea. Dan slide ada kat island, no worry. Yang ni ada kat island lah. Okay. Okay, this one. Okay, so CU. Okay, so a part of CU is properly, apa ni, decoder. Okay, decoder ni yang decode tadi lah. Maksudnya after dia, apa orang kata, dia ambil dia ambil data daripada memory. Okay, maksudnya dia fetch. Let's say dia fetch something daripada memory. Okay, biasanya memory lah. Okay, yang paling dekat. Dia lepas dia fetch, dia mesti tahu. Let's say kita kata dengan dia FA1A. Okay. So dia dah fetch, dia terima, simpan dalam register dia FA1A. So apa maksud FA1A? That's the idea of decoding. So FA1A mungkin boleh kata maksud dia add kan dengan value of 1A. Value of 1A nak tahu pula, you kena translate gunakan that apa tu, from hex to decimal, contoh. Okay, so that's the idea of decoding. And then the next one, where is it? Okay, so it's proper. Okay, when an instruction is fetched from the memory, the instruction is then sent to instruction decoder. Okay, okay, this is class, and then the intervention is called instruction. So this is the second step lah. Okay, the first one tadi kita fetch. So after fetch kita decode. Okay, so bila kita decode, mungkin kita kena execute. Okay, so that's the idea of ALU. So ALU akan perform the execution part. Okay, so the instruction tadi bila kita decode, it can be add, subtract, divide, multiply, and or exclusive. Okay, and also not. Okay. So what's the function of ALU? Okay. So ALU, dalam ALU pun dia ada register dia sendiri. So dia akan ada register. So logic register maksudnya this is where you do the AND and OR. Okay. Okay, that's the logic part. So comparator, this is where you do less than, more than, larger than and so on. So shift register, okay. So shift register. Shifter ni maksudnya you are shifting your register. You can shift to the left or shift to the right. Okay. So shift left, shift right, shift to the left, move to the left. Okay. Shift left maksudnya lebih kurang you darab 2, shift right maksudnya lebih kurang you divide by 2. Okay. And then it's also control the, it's also have the ALU controller. Okay. Okay. So, okay. Oh, ada explain kat sini. Compare the magnitude. Okay. This is the larger than, less than tu lah. Okay. And then from the AND and OR exclusive, okay, control is control the whole ALU. Okay. And then shift left or shift right. Okay. Except from shift left and shift right, you also have rotate left and rotate right. Okay. It's this. Okay. So the next thing dalam siapa namanya, dalam CPU, you have register. Okay. So register dalam CPU ni ada terlalu banyak lah. Okay. Kalau kita nak cerita. So yang besar yang dalam yang kita kena tahu dalam this chapter adalah kita kena tahu PC tadi pun, program counter tadi pun adalah register. Okey, PC tadi. IR instruction register pun adalah register, nama pun instruction register. So aside from that, kita ada MAR, memory address register, kita ada MDR, memory data register. Okey, MDR pula ada banyak jenis. Okey. So register a single permanent storage location. Okey. Dia permanent storage location, not the data is permanent, the location is permanent. Maksudnya kalau you kata that register is AX, dia akan jadi AX. Kalau BX register, dia akan jadi BX. Okay. And then what's next? Within the CPU, used for particular, okay, this is okay. Used to hold binary value, shorten use of hexadecimal. Okay. Temporarily for storage, manipulating and simple calculation. So why we need register ni lah. Okay, why we need it? Register is the basic working component. Okay, each register serve a particular. Okay. Okay. So what is register? Register may hold data being processed, instruction being executed, memory or I/O instruction, the address of your peripheral device. Okay. Keep track of the status of computer condition. So this is a flag register. Okay. Kita ada flag register juga. So primary, four primary operation by register. Okay, can be load value. Okay, add or subtract, shift. Okay, ni you all boleh baca. And then instruction register. Okay, so instruction register hold the actual instruction. Yang ni maksudnya, bila you dah decode, kan tadi the first step kita fetch. After fetch, kita decode. So once you decode, you will know what to do. Okay. So what once you dah decode, the the uncoded, okay, yang you dah decode tu, okay, akan disimpan di dalam instruction register. Okay. So dia akan memegang instruction sebenar. Okay. So program counter, okay, dia akan sentiasa bertambah satu. Okay. So it both a counter and also a register, dia akan hold the next address to be executed. Okay. Sebab bila kita address ini, kadang-kadang kita skip. So dia kena tahu kat mana yang next one, kat mana yang next one. Okay. Yang ni you kena tengok dalam assembly language kot nampak. Okay. So okay, so this is another one. So dia biasa add by one lah. Okay, so it then generate put the number. Okay, counter register. Okay, counter. Okay, and then the program. Okay, nothing. Program counter. When the current instruction is finished, the above step are repeated. That's normal lah. Dia akan ulang. Does the program counter continuously generate sequential address? So dia akan ulang, maksud dia akan ulang adalah dia akan ulang the machine cycle. Okay, tapi addressing dia akan berterusan. Okay. Okay, so register macam tadi kita yang saya cakap. Okay, so the important register is MAR, memory address register, and also MDR. Maksudnya bila you get an address, sebab we have to remember back what a bus can do. Okay, so in the end tak kisah daripada mana, the memory is connected by a bus. Okay. So bus can do three things. Dia boleh bawa tiga benda. It can carry address, okay. It can carry data, and it can carry control. Okay. So kalau control tak ada masalah lah. Okay. Sebab kita dah ada instruction register tadi untuk simpan data. Okay. So untuk simpan data daripada data bus, dia akan masuk dalam data. Dia akan masuk dalam MDR, memory data register. Kalau nak simpan address daripada address punya line, address punya bus, dia akan simpan dalam memory address register. Okay. Next one. So testers flag. Ini lagi satu register. Okay. Kita ada banyak jenis register untuk flag ni. Okay. Yang ni kita akan tengok bila kita buat assembly language. Okay. So apa yang dia simpan adalah dia simpan carry. Carry ni maksudnya bila you tambah-tambah binary tu, kadang-kadang kan ada lebih kan, yang kita ignore tu kan. So the ignore part tu actually kita tak ignore. Okay. In computer dia tak ada ignore semudah itu. Okay. So bila you tambahkan two binary ada lebih kat depan, selama ni kita ignore kan. So but now instead of you ignore, okay, sebenarnya apa yang berlaku dalam CPU, dia akan masuk ke dalam carry flag. Okay. So and juga bila you belajar binary hari tu, ingat tak? When it start with 0, kita akan assume dia as positive. When it start with 1, kita akan assume dia as what we call that negative. Okay, so the 0 and 1 actually will be stored inside our sign flag. Okay, and then kita juga ada overflow flag. Okay, so overflow ni kadang-kadang bila you tambah, okay, you punya komputer 32 bit katakan, ataupun macam sekarang 64 bit. But when you add two number, okay, and suddenly dia terlebih. Okay, maksudnya macam register tu tak cukup lah. Maksudnya bila you tambah 64 bit ni dengan 64 bit ni, tiba-tiba result dia jadi 64 bit. So yang terlebih satu tu, dia tak, dia akan masuk ke dalam overflow. Okay, so aside from that, okay, flag juga dia akan simpan untuk power failure. So yang ini yang membolehkan komputer bila dia start, dia tahu tadi you stop dekat mana. Okay, and then bila you on balik. Okay, so internal computer error, yang ini yang biasa kita akan dapat lah bila you blue screen, yeah. So once you blue screen, you punya komputer kena restart ataupun kena shutdown tu lah. Tapi bila you start balik, dia boleh keluar message, yeah, yang tadi apa ni, kena dump, yeah, you punya data kena dump, nak hantar ke Microsoft ke tak. So where they store all this, they store inside the internal error punya flag, yeah. So status register, register dia hanya boleh simpan satu value lah, basically 1 or 0, ada atau tak ada. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so tu je lah yang register buat. Dia ada satu bit je, ada tak ada, ada tak ada. Sebab tu tadi kalau terlebih pun 64 dengan 64 bit you tambah terlebih, dia akan masuk dalam overflow register. Okay, yang satu tu. Okay, so the next one is the system clock. Yang ni yang menjadikan you punya CPU tu sebagai you punya jantung. Okay, so macam mana cara dia kira? Okay, simple je the idea. When you have your heart, okay, dia mesti ada beat lah. Dia memberikan beat. Okay, yang ni you boleh baca lah. So how fast is the beat? Senang je nak kira dia. Ni tengok ni. Okay, so how fast is the beat? Okay, kita conteng sikit kat sini. So let's say macam kita suka beli komputer lah. Okay, you beli 5, berapa komputer? 5 gig lah sekarang. 5 giga first. Right, 5 giga hertz. Okay, 5 gig ni dalam bentuk hertz ni, so ini sama dengan this is the result of 1/s. Saat, second. Okay, eh lama, what happened? Oh tak boleh ada equal kat depan. So 5 gig ni is basically mana kita dapat, dia dapat daripada 1 per second. So how fast is your computer? Okay, so macam mana kita nak tahu? Simple je. So apa kita boleh buat? Apa kita boleh buat? Mana saya punya ni? Oh kat sini. So, so apa kita boleh buat? Okay, so let's say kita kata 5 gig. 5 gig ni macam mana? Rupa dia 3 hertz. So berapa besar 5 gig? Ada ke komputer 5 gig tu? Mungkin macam laju sangat kan, ambil 2.4. 2.4 macam ni, macam ni. Ya, i7 kata lagi. So let's say kita tengok dekat spec dia. So kita tengok yang ni, 4GB memory. So is it Dell? Okay, so how fast is the processor? Up to okay, 4.1. Okay, so how fast is 4.1 gig? Lama. Sini nak ni. Gigahertz. Okay. Macam ni lah. Okay, 4.1 kita bundarkan lah. 4 gig. So 4 gig, this is kilo mega giga. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so how fast it is, you divide back. Okay, Allah, tak boleh nak tunjuk pun. Boleh tunjuk, tak ada masalah. Okay, so if you say your computer is 4 gig, okay, say you say your computer is 4 gig, okay, so maksudnya in term of second, okay, dia adalah selajunya yang dicakap tadi. So this one actually means universiti. Ini nak buka. Sudahlah saya buka sendiri. Okay. So macam mana kita nak tahu? Oh ni ada. Okay. So this is the number. Okay. So untuk pengiraan mudah dalam komputer, maksudnya let's say 1+1. Okay. Berapa laju komputer buat 1+1 is actually untuk yang 4GB punya processor adalah selaju 0.00000000025 saat. Okay. Ah, boleh. Dia keluar. Second. So if you say your computer is 4GB, so how fast is the 4GB? Ah, inilah kelajuan dia. Okay. Untuk buat simple operation, store 1+1 katakan, it will take about 0.00000125 seconds. Okay. So that's how fast a computer can calculate. Okay. So this goes to all. Okay, maksudnya kalau kita manusia 1+1 memang senang. Tapi kalau kita bagi 1+1, 2+3, 4+5, sampai 100 katakan berapa cepat kita boleh kira. So komputer hanya perlu buat benda tu berapa cepat tu. Okay. So dia akan lagi laju dari kita lah. Sebab tu kita gunakan komputer. Okay. So that how fast is the clock, the heartbeat of a computer. Berapa laju dia berfikir. Okay. So mega giga. Oh betul lah. Okay. So the next one. Eh dah habis ke tadi? Each tick. Okay. Therefore faster. Okay. Tak ada masalah. In some clock execute single tick. Okay. No problem. Instruction is fetched by K. Okay. Okay. Instruction time, executed time, turnaround time. Okay. So dalam komputer kita ada istilah turnaround time lah. The total time. Okay, so turn around time maksudnya bila dia complete the whole machine cycle. Okay, tapi bila dia do this part, okay, daripada fetching, okay, ke decode, dia kita akan kata dia as instruction time. Okay, and then execute and store back, kita akan kata dia sebagai execution time. But the whole process kita panggil sebagai turn around. So bus. Okay. So bus macam tadi, a bus is parallel. Kenapa dia parallel? Sebab dia bawa tiga data yang dalam masa yang sama. Okay. Address, data dengan control. Okay. So this is a bus. Okay. So dia akan bawa data, dia akan bawa address and juga dia akan bawa control. Okay. So fetch cycle. Okay. So ini dah nak habis dah? No. So this one, the fetch execute instruction cycle. So maksudnya fetch to execute, maksudnya the idea is to move data between register ke, daripada memory ke register ke, to share and so on. Okay. To add, sebab dia termasuk fetch and execute. Okay. So bila you fetch, execute. Okay. So fetch until execute, maksudnya dia dah lalu lah. Fetch, okay, and then dia decode and then dia execute. Okay, so instruction cycle. So then the last one dia akan store back. Okay, so ni tak ada apa-apa. Yang ni yang apa orang kata, cerita dia secara general lah. Okay, apa yang berlaku. Okay, ni you all baca sendirilah. Okay, the next one, first register yang pakai. Okay, general purpose accumulator. Accumulator ni basically dia dalam you punya AX. Okay, so you ada banyak accumulator, you ada AX, BX, CX and DX untuk hold you punya data. Okay. And then kita ada program counter yang tadi yang akan menentukan what next to do, instruction. Kalau you dah decode, you find out that is instruction, so you akan simpan dalam instruction register. Kalau you dah decode, you tahu itu data, baru you masuk dalam data register. Kalau you decode, you kata to address, dia akan masuk dalam address register. Okay. Okay, so ini dia bercerita pasal apa yang berlaku lah secara notanya. Okay. So yang ini, kalau tengok yang ni pun tak faham. Okay. So yang ini pun, ni untuk you all baca lepas kita discuss about this one. Okay. Sekejap eh. Okay, so let's discuss about this. Okay, so the first one, kalau kita tengok this one, dia kata program counter. Okay, so usually the question also go like this lah. Dia akan bagi start macam ni. Okay, so apa maksud ni program counter ni kalau kita nak cerita? Okay, so kita cerita daripada program dia lah. Kita translate ni dulu. Macam mana keadaan dia. Okay, so program counter equal to 44 tu maksudnya. Okay, maksudnya dalam komputer dia tadi tu, you dah tahu dalam ni mesti ada PC kan? Itu what? Mana dia? Okay, program counter kita nak letak kat mana? Sebab kita akan update selalu. Let's lah, kita letak kat sini. Okay, so let's say kita letak kat sini. Okay, so kita letakkan ni white ni. Okay, stop. Okay, so tulisan hitam. Okay, so this is your PC, program counter. Okay, so program counter you, do you start anything? Biasanya dalam program counter tu dah ada value. Dia kata value 44. Okay, so apa jadi dengan value 44 ni? Next one. Okay, so dekat dalam value in memory, location 44. Okay, so maksudnya okay, kita delete yang lain ni ya. So this one kita delete dulu, kita jadikan dia semua memory. Okay, this one kita jadikan dia yellow. Okay, dan yang ni kita buang dulu. Maksudnya kita discuss dia in term of memory lah. Okay, so this one kita buang lagi. And okay, let's say we make this L as our main memory. Oops. Okay, so at location 44. So dalam memory dia akan ada address. Dia start daripada macam mana? Okay, dia start daripada 000 or by verse. And biasanya, and untuk senang faham, okay, and dia akan habis dengan FF. Tapi tak adalah, macam ni je. Maksudnya kalau memory you 4GB lagi panjang, instead of FFFF, dia mungkin FFFF. Okay, maksudnya it depend. Tapi kita discuss dalam bentuk 4 darab 4, 16 bit punya addressing. 16 bit punya addressing. Okay, supaya senang nak cerita. Okay, so somewhere somehow dalam memory ni mesti ada location 44. Okay, dalam bentuk decimal. Okay, so in location 44, okay, apa yang ada dalam location 44 tu, dia akan ada instruction 599. Okay, so 599. Okay, so let's say lah yang 599 ni tak boleh juga. Tak apa, kita kata 599 dalam bentuk, semua ni dalam bentuk yang ni dalam bentuk decimal. Okay, so the next one, kalau kita tengok kat sini, macam mana saya nak bagi share semua? Saya buat macam ni. Okay, so the next one, okay, at location 45, nampak? Okay, addressing dia kan? At location 45 akan ada value 198. Okay, and then at location 46, okay, akan ada value 399. Next one at location 98, there will be a value of 77 yang kita tak tahu apa guna dia lagi, kita tak pakai pun. And then at 99 there will be a value of 210. Okay, so kalau kita tengok kat sini, okay, so 599 19 tu sebenarnya, so this is actually a number yang bukan number sebenar lah orang kata. This is a number yang hanya untuk pemahaman. Okay, so from here sebenarnya kita boleh tengok, kita boleh split kan 59 tu. Alamak, dia jadi macam tu pula. Nombor dash. Okay, 5-9 kan. Okay, and then this one, okay, kita translate yang ni dah. Okay, so this one actually kita boleh translate dia macam ni supaya you all senang. So 599, okay, 5 tu dalam kes ni adalah example untuk load data from 99. Okay, and then 198 maksudnya adalah add into 90, add value Ready? Okay. Okay. And then last kali adalah stop. So ini sebenarnya complete lah kita punya machine cycle. Okay. Our instruction cycle. Okay. So this is maksudnya. So 5 ni stand for load. Okay. 99 ni is the address. Load value daripada 99. Maksudnya loadkan value 210 ni sebenarnya. Okay. And then addkan dengan value from 98. Okay. So bila nak add pun you kena fetch balik lah. Okay. And then baru you store kan. Baik. Okay. So the next one. So kalau kita tengok this one. Okay. So how we can show this is movable. Okay. So kita tengok kat sini. Bawah ni kan dia kata. So the first one, PC will move to MAR. Maksudnya value daripada PC ni dia akan move kepada MAR. Okay. So kita ada MAR kat sini. So MAR akan dapat value 44. Okay. So what will the MAR do with 44? Okay. So MAR pun dah dia memang address register kan. So what we do, dia akan masuk ke dalam bus line ni. Okay. Dia akan masuk ke dalam bus line ni dan pergi kepada location 44. Okay. So bila dia dah pergi kepada location 44, dia akan terima 599. Okay. So 599 ni dia akan ambil dan dia akan simpan ke dalam MDR. Okay. So dekat dalam MDR akan terima value 599. Okay. So bila dah terima 599 ni, apa dia akan buat pula? CU akan translate tadi. Okay, instruction tu dia akan translate. So dia akan kata 5 ni, okay. So dia akan masuk ke dalam instruction register. Okay. 599 ni nak buat apa? Okay. So dalam instruction register, dia akan terima value 5, kita tak dash. Okay. 5 dash 99. Okay. Stop. 5 dash 99. Okay. So 5 dash 99 ni, what does it mean? Okay, so 5-99 ni sebenarnya kalau kita translate maksudnya adalah load kan value daripada location 99. So bila IR dah tahu, okay, load kan something. So apa dia akan buat? Okay, so now apa dia akan buat? So dia akan send this 99 back to MAR. So how am I going to prove it? Okay, so instead of 44. Okay, so sekarang maksudnya the value of MAR dia akan update to 99. Okay, so what it will do? Okay, so MAR akan ambil akan tengok, dia akan kata, okay, loadkan, okay, instruction kata loadkan value daripada location 99. So MAR 99 dia akan pergi pada sini. Nampak tak? Okay, so what it will do? Dia akan go to memory. Memory location 99. Oh, dekat location 99 you will see the value of 210. So 210 ni will be bring back to the CPU and store at the MDR. Okay, so we will store the value of 210 dekat MDR. Okay, so once you store that one, so complete the first cycle, the first instruction. Maksudnya ni dah siap. So once this is done, okay. Alamak, ini pun kita move ke bawah. Okay. So once that's done, so PC will increase by 1. So it will become 45. Okay tak? So that is the first cycle dalam kita, the fetch cycle dalam kita punya Totten machine cycle. Ada soalan tak for this one? Any question so far about fetch cycle? Okay. Okay. So fetch cycle, okay. Ulang. Ulang. Okay, okay. Boleh, tak ada masalah. Yeah. So kita dah tahu ni dah okay, ni okay. Yeah. Bagi dia cantik sikit. MAR, Memory Address Register. Tanya-tanya. MAR stand for Memory Address Register. Okay, saya try ulang kan. Okay, kita delete this one. Marih. Marih ke markah? BIOS Basic Input Output System. Wih, yang itu chapter 1 tu. Jauh tanya tu. Oh, it's okay, it's okay. Okay. Saya ulang balik eh. Okay. So, saya letak yang tu dekat sebelah. Supaya senang kita cerita. Okay. So, this one eh. So, bila kita start komputer, maksudnya you dah boot apa semua kan. So, inside your program counter, dia akan simpan what to do next. Okay. So, let's say you are at that point already. Maksudnya dekat dalam PC, apa-apa pun dalam komputer ni dia akan start dengan PC. Okay. Program counter, dia akan start dari situ. So, dalam PC you ada value of 44. Okay. So, 44. Okay, so apa dia akan buat? 44 ni adalah dia punya address. What's next to do? Where to fetch from the main memory? Okay, so dekat dalam memory. Okay, so dalam PC ada 44. So 44 ni will be passed from PC to the MAR. Okay, so once masuk dalam MAR ni memang tak ada kerja lain lah. Kerja dia adalah untuk pergi kepada memory tu. Cuma bezanya nak ambil ke, nak load ke, nak store, nak simpan. Okay. So in this case, kebiasaannya kita akan load dulu. Okay. So bila kita pergi kepada MAR ni, okay. So dia tak ada kerja lain, dia just ambil the value of 599. So 599 ni, so daripada PC pergi ke MAR, okay. So PC move to MAR. So MAR, okay, dia akan go to the memory location 44, and at 44 they get 599. So this 599 will be returned back using the data bus. Okay, so it will be sent to this one, memory data register. So dalam this one ada 599. Subtract to set siap lah. Okay. So dia akan So 599 ni bila dia dah sampai dalam memory data register, dia akan tengok. Sebab dia tahu ini adalah arahan untuk buat something. So, apa yang kita nak buat? Okay. So, apa yang kita nak buat? So, dia akan hantar kepada instruction register to be decoded. So, dalam ni kita akan dia akan terima value 599. Okay. So, so dia akan terima value 599 juga. Baik. Baik pun. Okay. Okay, dia akan terima value 599. So dalam IR ni dia akan split lah. So dia tengok 599, this is not address ni, dia kata. So what it will do, it will split. Dia akan split kan. Yeah. So it become 599. Yeah. So 599 ni dia akan further translate kan. What does the 599 mean? 599 mean load something from location 99. Okay. So once dia dah tahu, oh kena load something. Okay, okay, I understand. So load something. Okay. So 99 ni will be sent back to the MAR. So maksudnya MAR daripada value 44, so dia akan jadi value 99. So bila dah masuk ke MAR, memang tak ada kerja lain, dia akan masuk ke dalam memori balik, pergi ke location 99, kemudian dia jumpa value 210. So 210 will be sent back via the data bus. Okay. So and then masuk dalam MDR. So dalamnya akan masuk 210. Okay. So daripada data bus, okay. kita akan, okey, dah masuk 2.1.0. Ha, siap. Okey, so dah masuk dalam 2.1.0. Kalau you tengok kat sini, dia akan ada MDR pindah kepada accumulator. Okey, so kita accumulator. Accumulator ada banyak. Accumulator. Okey, so accumulator. So dalam accumulator, dia akan ambil value this one. Dia akan storekan ke sini. Okay. So dah masuk value dalam accumulator. Baik. So selesai. Okay. So once dah selesai, dah tahu apa nak buat. Okay. Accumulator ni basically kalau dalam assembly language, you ada banyak lah register untuk accumulator. You ada AX, the accumulator. You ada BX untuk base dia. C untuk control, and then B you ada untuk data, untuk overflow and so on. Okay. So this one you masukkan dalam 2.10. Okay, you dah masuk sini. So once dah selesai this cycle, fetching cycle, so what will it do? It will increase by 1. So when it increase by 1, so dalam PC daripada 44 jadi 45. Okay. Eh? Okay, okay. Any question? Tak ada? Okay. So let's move on to the next one. So lepas you load, kalau you tengok ada instruction next kan, nak tambahan. So how do you add? Ha, ni dia cerita in detail lah. Okay. So the next one nak buat add pula, so dia akan buat benda yang sama. Dia akan start daripada PC. So tadi kan PC dah increase to 45. Okay. So maksudnya PC akan hantar value 45 kepada MA. So, instead of dalam ni ada 99, you will send the 45 to the address register. So, once go to address register, tak ada benda lain dia nak buat, dia akan masuk ke dalam kita punya main memory. So, at main memory location 45, dia akan jumpa instruction 198. So, 198 ni will be sent back to the memory data register. So, it will be 198. So let's cancel lah this value. Okay. So 198. So once receive 198, 198 will be sent to the instruction register. So maksudnya yang ini tadi dia terpadam. Okay. So this one will be cancel. So 198 will be sent to instruction register. So dia akan buat the same thing. Dia akan splitkan. Okay. To find out what does 18 means. 198 means. Okay. So what does 198 mean? Dia akan masuk ke situ. So dia translate 198 mean is basically it mean apa maksud dia? Akan dengan dalam value accumulator dengan value daripada 98. Okay. So what will it do? Okay, dia akan add kan. Nampak tak? Accumulator kan? Dia kata jadi 797. So how does this happen? Sebab instruction register dah tahu nak buat add. Okay, so tak, bila you buat add, you boleh add step by step ataupun you boleh add terus value daripada memory. Tak ada masalah. Okay, so dalam case ni dia addkan terus value daripada accumulator dengan value dengan daripada apa namanya? Register. Okay, so kenapa jadi 797? 7. So salah salin. Betul lah. Okay. Accumulator ke dia translate? Tak apa. Kejap kita check. Okay. So this one. Bila kita addkan. Okay. So kita addkan dengan value daripada 98. So this one. Okay. So basically what happen in accumulator, dia akan tambahkan dengan value 77. So kita tambahkan. So the new value inside accumulator will be 980. Okay. Kenapa value dia tak sama? Kita try check. Tak apalah, biar je lah value dia. Okay, so once kita dah add, okay, so once dah add, aku tak sama, pilih dulu 7720. Crazy. Okay, so once dah add, sama macam tadi. Okay, so kita akan update value PC akan jadi 46. Okay tak? Untuk addition. Kenapa tak sama lah? Dia pakai nombor hex ke? Berapa? Any question? Ada soalan tak? To 10. Yes. Masuk. 87. Oh, dia tak translate. 987 sama tak dengan nota tadi? Tak sama juga. Oh, okey. Yes, tak sama. Next 3B. Salah kot ni, yang ni. Oh, why? Okay, tak apa. So kalau dia tengok kan, lepas dia dah tahu nak ambil apa value, oh saya terskip yang tu. Lepas dia dah tahu nak add dengan value daripada 98, so apa dia buat? Okay, so dia akan carry 98. Okay, so dia akan bawa, nampak tak? A tambah MDR kan? Okay, so MDR dia tambah MDR. Kalau dia kata tambah MDR, mana boleh tambah MDR? Dia tambah direct ni. Tak apalah. Okey, dia sebenarnya tak tambah MDR oh. Kalau dia tambah MDR, kita mesti load juga akan ke dalam MDR. Dia boleh, kita boleh tambah direct. Tak apa, nanti dalam assembly language kita tengok macam mana dia function. Okay. So then the last one dia akan jadi PC tambah this one lah. Okay. 98 tambah MDR. Oh, kena load juga eh dalam MDR. Okay. Ikut yang ni. Apa? So dia load temporary. Okay. So dalam MDR ya, daripada value this one. Okay, so dia akan loadkan with the value of 777. So kita tambahkan these two value. Okay, so kita akan dapat 980. Kenapa notes dapat 787? Okay, so the next one. Okay, PC. Okay, ini untuk store. Okay. So dia store dia akan lebih kurang sama macam load tadi. Okay. So at 46 apa dia kata? So 46 kata 399. Eh sorry, kena cerita. So 46 kita akan tengoklah location 46. Okay. Sorry. So 46 dia akan masuk ke sini. Okay, dia akan masuk ke sini. Okay. So dia akan update this value. Okay. So 46 here. Yeah. So 46 akan terima value daripada 46 masuk ke dalam MDR. So dia akan jadi 399. Okay. So 399. Okay. So from 399 dah tambah dalam MDR. Okay. So daripada sini dia akan masuk ke dalam sini. 399. Eh sorry. This one. Okay. So 399. So what does 399 mean? Okay. So 399. So maksudnya store kan ke location 99. Okay. So dah tahu nak buat store. So, store kan ke location 99. naik. Okay, so bila dah tahu store, so maksudnya 99 ni dia akan masuk dekat sini. So sini masuk 99. So once dah masuk 99, so value daripada accumulator akan dipaskan kepada MDR. Okay, then only barulah value daripada accumulator pergi ke MDR, boleh pergi ke sini. Okay, so maksudnya 99 ni instead of 210, okay, so sekarang dia akan simpan value 99. Okay, so bila dah settle this part, okay, so PC akan tambah lagi satu, so dia akan jadi 47. Astaghfirullahaladzim, saya tak rakam ni, saya rakam tak? Did I record this one? Yes, okay, so this one, then where is it? So strike through, okay, so this one dia masuk sini, oh, tak strike through lagi. And then this one strike through. Okay, so dia akan update the value of in the location, siapa location, eh sorry, why, apa value asal dia tadi lah, 210. Okay, so maksudnya daripada value 210 dia akan jadi value 980. Okay, so dia akan update the value lah. Okay, so that's how a complete apa orang kata, a complete machine cycle is that. Okay, so dia ada 4 instruction dalam tu, 4 set of instruction. Okay, so complete machine cycle tadi dah habis lah. Okay, so apa, complete machine cycle, what was it, hilang lah. Okay, nama penuh dia, istilahnya secara teori. Okay, okay, so dalam kita punya machine cycle, okay, so yang inilah contoh complete tadi. So maksudnya kita a complete machine cycle, kita start dengan tadi load 99 tu. Maksudnya that one we do the fetching part. So every time we do something, dia akan melalui the decoding process. Okay, so bila kita dah dapat decode, and then baru kita execute, which are bila kita start buat add dengan add 98. Okay, and then kita dah execute, after that we will store it back the value inside our memory. Alhamdulillah, habis, terlambat sikit. Okay, so any question for today? Nanti tu, okay, insyaAllah. Okay, so that's all for today. Alhamdulillah. Ada soalan? Tak ada? Sorry terlama sikit compare dengan what promise, terlebih 15 minit. Okay, so saya akan try apa ni namanya, update dia, update pula apa nama istilah dia, render this video first. Okay, nanti saya try upload kat YouTube lah. Okay, okay, so that's all for today. Thank you class. Thank you. Thank you for attending the class.
Thank you sir.
Okay, welcome. Jangan lupa isi attendant. Okay, stay safe. Jangan keluar rumah, duduk rumah. Yang kat college, stay. Ada lagi yang kat college ke? Okay, yang kat rumah jaga diri, jangan keluar, jangan main-main. Okay, okay, yang kat rumah jangan keluar. Isi attendant kat mana? Dekat Google Form. Cuba tengok dekat group. Okay, okay, thank you, thank you. Sorry, sorry for any delay dalam video ni yang saya terskip apa semua. Okay, nanti nak slide ada kat island kalau nak cepat, no problem. Okay, saya akan upload slide, akan share jugalah dekat WhatsApp dulu. Okay, apa ni, tambah satu juga ke? Laju sangat. Ya, where's the message? Tambah satu. So, kalau PC store 99, PC tambah satu. After 47. Ya, yes. Kan dah store kan? Dekat value 99. Kan kita tambah satu. Ready for the next one. Yang kita tak tahu apa dia. I shouldn't do it this one like this. I should do a little bit further down. Waduh, nampak kan? Addressing dia. Yes, still tambah satu. Sebab store 99 ni, dia tak update kat PC. PC tu yang akan bertambah satu. Maksudnya dekat 47 ni mungkin after 46 ada 47 kan? 47 mungkin you nak buat lain. You nak buat 500 kan? 5101 katakan. So dekat 101 ni mungkin ada benda lain you nak buat, mungkin ada value lain. Nampak tak? Okay. Good question. Okay. So dia sebenarnya continuous. Okay. Sebab once you go to operating system nanti, you akan nampak kalau you perasan bukan operating system je lah. Kalau if you pernah what you call that, defrag your hard disk untuk hard disk yang lama kan. Siapa yang pakai hard disk yang bukan single, apa tu namanya, yang bukan SSD. Okay. Kalau you bukan pakai SSD, you boleh defrag. Okay. So bila you defrag your hard disk, ada tak defrag dalam kumpulan? Oh, ada. Okay. So you can defrag your hard disk. Okay. So bila you defrag your hard disk, analyze. Boleh? Zaman sekarang ada lagi tak? Okay. Saya tak sure. So kalau zaman dulu lah. Okay. So kalau zaman dulu, bila you defrag something, defrag. Okay. So defragmentation ni. Okay. So hard disk ke ataupun memory pun dia akan run lebih kurang macam hard disk lah. Fragmentation or boleh lah. Ada tak gambar? Oh, zaman sekarang dah tak ada gambar. Window. Ha, kalau you tengok gambar, bila you defrag something, gambar ni ada maksud. Maksudnya ada part dalam hard disk kan, macam ni kan. Ada yang tak nampak sangat. Yang ni lah. Ada part dalam hard disk you boleh ubah. Okay, nampak eh? Unmovable part. Ada part yang you tak boleh ubah. Yang tak boleh ubah ni biasanya adalah system file. Dia dah fix kat situ. Okay. So sama juga macam memory lah. Why, kenapa saya cerita yang ini? Sebab dalam memory, when we talk about memory, okay, bila we talk about memory, dia akan bahagikan. Yang ini untuk instruction, yang ini untuk data, yang ini untuk buffer and so on. Okay. Dia ada function-function dia lah. Okay. Tapi yang tu you akan cover 513. Mana 513? Kat mana? Boleh leave eh? Siapa nak leave? 5 palang 1 palang 3 kat mana ni eh? 5. Oh, ini saya nak tunjukkan dia buat. Oh, faham. 513 yang kat depan ni kan. Okey, yang ini, okey, saya nak tunjukkan macam mana IR tu dibuat decoding. Maksudnya bila dia terima value dalam siapa ni namanya, dalam RAM, okey, dia tak ada dash ni, dia 599 198 399. Okay. So 599, okay, bila dia fetch daripada memory, dia akan masuk ke dalam MDR 599. So dalam 599 ni, dia bila masuk dalam MDR, dia terima dia sebagai data. Okay. Tapi bila dia dah, so untuk tahu 599 ni apa maksud dia, dia akan masuk dalam instruction register 599. So bila dia jumpa 599, dia akan split kan. Nombor yang depan, adalah nombor instruction. Nombor yang belakang adalah nombor memory. Ini untuk mudahkan pemahaman kita. Tapi dalam komputer tak adalah semudah ini. Okay. So, control. Control tu apa yang kita boleh buat. Control tu maksudnya you nak load ke, nak apa tu orang kata, nak ambil data daripada RAM, load, ataupun you nak save, you nak store data kepada RAM, ataupun you nak buat operasi tambah ke, tolak ke, what do you want the computer to do? Ha, itu maksud load. Okay. So untuk apa nak buat, CEO yang akan control. Okay. Macam mana CEO nak dapat arahan? CEO akan dapat arahan daripada instruction register yang dah diikut data daripada RAM tadi. Itu okay. Kegunaan control lah. Sebab sebab control ni macam saya cakap lah, what we learn daripada kita baby. Control macam mana nak makan, control macam mana nak jalan. Okay. Tapi untuk belajar tambah tolak, kita kena pergi sekolah. So yang itu kita pakai kita punya otak juga, tapi the part of ALU instead of the part of CU dengan IR. Okay? Okay. Kalau tak ada soalan, that's all, that's all. Anything else? Okay. Any more question? Load at store 2 as instruction. Yes, you are right. MDR, memory data register. Yes, load at store, that is instruction. Itulah instruction yang dia cuba decode. Sebab dalam RAM, dia tak boleh simpan perkataan LOAD. Kan? Dia hanya boleh simpan binary number. Kalau manusia, kita tengok benda tu as decimal number. So, kita kata maybe value dia 5. Okay. 5 ni maksud dia apa? Bila dia lalu dalam instruction register, dia decode 5 ni maksudnya load. Contoh, okay. Dia bagi contoh numbering. Numbering ni akan berubah. Kalau you tengok soalan exam you, kali ni 5 load. Next time mungkin 3 load suka hati dia. Sebab ini adalah example mudah. Okay. Dia simplifiedkan the number. Sebab tu dia letak explanation kat sebelah. 5 tu load. Okay. Nah, kalau betul-betul tak ada. Okay. MDR. MDR ni memory data register. Okay. MDR ni maksudnya apa sahaja yang nak masuk dalam CPU, okay, dia mesti melalui MDR. Dia macam orang kata macam mana? Okay. Data daripada external hard disk, you cucuk thumb drive. Okay. Bila you cucuk thumb drive punya data akan masuk ke dalam main memory, into your main memory. From your main memory, dia akan lalu cache tu, and then dia akan masuk ke dalam CPU. Kat dalam CPU nak simpan kat siapa? Dia akan simpan dalam memory data register. Okay. So dia macam sebenarnya dia macam RAM lah. Macam thumb drive juga lah dalam you punya CPU. Okay. Tapi hanya untuk simpan data. Okay. So the data, data macam kita belajar awal-awal, data is useless information. To make it an information, dia must be translated. Tapi dalam CPU kita tak translate, kita pakai istilah translate jugalah, interpret tadi kan. Kita pakai istilah decode. 599 tak ada makna. Okay. Tapi bila kita data daripada RAM kata 599, masuk dalam MDR 599 tak ada makna. Masuk dalam IR 599, IR akan diikut 599. Okey, splitkan 5, splitkan 99. 5 instruction, 99 address. Apa maksud 5 instruction 5? Maksud dia load. Load apa? Load daripada address. Address mana? Address 99. Okay. So that's what it mean lah. Sebab tu kita start awal-awal tu dengan what is data, what is information. So apa sahaja yang masuk dalam MDR, dia masih lagi useless. Okay. So dia hanya akan bererti, okay, when it come into instruction register, when it's decoded by the instruction register. Okay. Ada lagi soalan? Okay. It's okay, you can refer back. Kalau ada soalan boleh tanya. Yeah. Kalau you nak tanya Dr. Google pun boleh. Dia ada semua jawapan pasal komputer. Pasal bila COVID habis dia tak ada. Okay, next question. Any more? Tak ada? Okay. Oh, no problem. Okay, tak ada. Apa lagi left lah? Eh, jangan lupa isi attendant yang lambat join. Okay. Welcome.
Saya tak, tak saya tak ada pintu nak bukakan untuk you all. Okay. So tolonglah lah. Welcome. Okay, saya mana button ni lah. I need to stop the recording. Mana button? Okay, welcome. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Stop recording.